In this class, we are going to study about Compton effect, which is lecture 4 of unit 1, quantum mechanics. We shall see what is this Compton effect. Compton effect is the name given to the scattering of X-ray radiations by the electrons that are weakly bound to the atoms in the target. At this stage, we should remember that the target, it is graphite in this case, contains electrons that are tightly bound to the atom and also some of the electrons that are free or called as weakly bound to the atoms. It was the American physicist Arthur H. Compton who discovered this effect. The Compton effect can be explained on the basis of quantum theory of light. What is this quantum theory of light? We have seen E is equal to h nu in the previous lecture, where E is the energy, h is the Planck's constant, and nu is the frequency. It states that energy is given out in packets known as quanta. What is the significance or importance of Compton effect? Compton effect provides the direct confirmation the particle nature of electromagnetic radiation. This slide gives us the summary and the definition of what is Compton effect. Compton discovered that when a monochromatic radiation of high frequency, like X-rays, is scattered by a substance, the scattered radiation contains two components, one having a lower frequency or higher wavelength, and the other having same frequency or wavelength. The radiation of unchanged frequency in the scattered beam is known as unmodified radiation, while the radiation of a lower frequency or higher wavelength is called as modified radiation. This phenomenon is known as Compton effect. So we got to understand what is this modified component and what is this unmodified component in Compton effect. This diagram shows the collision between a photon and an electron. The photon is a monochromatic photon of wavelength lambda I, which comes and strikes an electron at rest in the target. The target is a graphite block. It is an elastic collision between the photon and the electron. When the photon collides with the electron, it loses energy and gets scattered at an angle theta. What happens to the electron? The electron gains energy and recoils at an angle phi. The Compton effect, as we have seen, contains two components, unmodified component and a modified component. Lambda I is the unmodified component, and lambda f is a modified component. Lambda f is greater than lambda I. Why does this happen? When the photon loses energy, its frequency decreases, and hence the wavelength will increase. The shift del lambda is equal to lambda final minus lambda initial, which is equal to h divided by m naught c into 1 minus cos theta, where h is the Planck's constant, m naught is the rest mass, c is the velocity of light, and theta is the scattering angles. As we have already seen, it contains a modified frequency or wavelength and an unmodified frequency or wavelength. This graph is between wavelength along the x-axis and intensity along the y-axis. The wavelength in the Compton effect is measured by using Bragg's law. It is a Bragg's X-ray spectrometer which captures these X-ray photons. And using Bragg's law, we are able to calculate the value of lambda. What does Bragg's law state? It is 2d sine theta is equal to n lambda. In the graph, we can see that we have got an initial wavelength lambda I, and a final wavelength lambda f. Lambda f, as you can see in the graph, is higher than lambda initial. Now, why do you get the modified wavelength and why do you get the unmodified wavelength? The modified wavelength occurs due to collision of X-ray photons with free electrons. On collision, the X-ray photons loses energy and hence frequency decreases or wavelength increases. Unmodified wavelength is due to collision of X-ray photons with the tightly bound electrons in the target. The target is graphite. The whole atom is involved in collision and hence M0 is the mass of the atom, which is large. Hence, the shift is negligible. So in this class, we have studied what is Compton effect, which is a collision between a photon, a monochromatic photon, and an electron at rest. It is an elastic collision. The photon strikes the electron and loses energy, and the electron gains energy. And in the process, we can see there is a shift in the wavelength. That shift, del lambda, is equal to lambda final minus lambda initial. This is what is Compton effect.